The next part of the tool to take a look at is the pixel editor and some of the drawing editor tools that we have included in NestMaker. The pixel editor should feel very familiar to anybody who has ever created anything in a computer graphics program. One thing that you can do is you can create new files. Let's talk a little bit about how it works before we get into how to use it. If you look at an example of a project, if you look at the graphic assets, this is what you're actually affecting when you're creating graphics. You're actually going to be affecting these files here. Some of these are for background graphics, some of them are for player graphics, some of them are for start screen graphics, etc., etc. And the problem is that the Nest needs graphics in a very particular way. In fact, it's just a long string of byte data that tells it, you know, basically what pixel to draw, going through which of one of those color slots inside of a group of a single tile. And that's what the Nest needs. And it's not like any other graphics format that you might work with, like bitmap or a PNG or, you know, any of the other file types that you, or JPEG, any other file types you might use normally. So when you're working in Photoshop and you want to go to GameMaker, you know, you make your graphic, you make your animation, you go to GameMaker and you load up the BMP, and it's that easy. With Nest, it's never really been that easy. And there's been really cool tools like Shiru's Nest Screen Tool, which allows you to export CHR files and work with CHR files and even import bitmap files. But they had to be 8-bit bitmap files, and it has to crank it down to three colors or make a decision as to what colors they should be. Like if you had a picture that was, you know, 100 colors, how does it know? And that's why you can only load 8-bit graphics into this. Where we wanted our tool to be able to work with any picture file at all, and then you can physically reduce it down into the needs of the Nest. And the way that our tool does it is with this black, red, green, blue scenario. And I want to show you an example. Let's take a look at an existing project. So this is an example. We're going to go back and forth to this of a platformer made in NestMaker. So I'm going to open a second NestMaker, and I'm going to open up desktop platformer. Save states platform. Okay, so this file has, you know, a whole bunch of backgrounds. Let's take a look at the assets for the background. So you can kind of see what these assets look like when run through this sub palette. And if I look at my overworld, here's what that ends up looking like through the game. But these graphics are not colorful. For instance, look at this ground. It's green and brown and brown, but it's not really the graphic that it's using. If I look at my graphic assets for this, looks like this. It's red, green, and blue. It's black, red, green, and blue. Black represents the zero color, red represents the one color, green represents the two color, and blue represents the three color. So if we think about it like that, and we look at the game, black is the zero color, right? Red is the one color, so anything that's red is going to translate to this color. So that's why we see green right here, because this is the color that's loaded into that place. Green translates to the two color, which is brown in this case. So anywhere where you see green in this BMP file translates through this slot to brown. And blue is the fourth color. And so anything that's blue over here translates through black, this last color here, which is black. So anywhere you see blue on this file, it's going to translate through that sub palette to black. So this was our clever way to sort of integrate BRGB, you know, a four color graphic file, and force it through this palette translation. But we wanted to create a tool that would allow you to be able to do that manually. So what we did was, we created the pixel editor, which you can load any graphic you want. It doesn't matter how complex it is. You can go to beta assets, graphics, and we can look at this entire tile set. And you can load this in and start working with it. However, if you export this, a lot of these values are gonna be null. In fact, if I go to show bad pixels, it's going to show only the bad pixels, which it showed all the pixels. All the pixels are currently bad. In order to get this into the format that we need to start making some adjustments. And what we're seeing is we're gonna see the good pixels. We can either look at it in red and black, red, green, blue format, like that tile set that I showed you over here. We can either look at it in this format, or we can look at it as translated through the current sub palette. So what we want to do is we want to get these tiles into a format that Nest can understand. And the first thing that we want to do is we want to start globally changing the color. And we talked about how over here, everything that was blue was going to translate through black. So everything that's this third color, there's last color, 0, 1, 2, 3, this third color should be blue. I should be able to turn that to blue. So I'm going to globally change black to blue like that. And you can already see how now this starts to resemble this file, right? But we don't want to see it that way. Maybe that's confusing. So basically we want that to be black. We want this, what's green to here, to be red like that. And we want what's brown to be green like that. And so this, if now if I show my bad pixels, I can see the good pixels disappeared, the ones that the Nest can understand. And I can start going through and figuring out, okay, what should these other things be? Well, this should be green. So I'm gonna get green like that. And these should be blue like this. Okay, so now if I translate that back through red, green, blue, now this is starting to resemble this, but we're not really worried about that. That was just to demonstrate what's actually happening and the effect that we want. Let's just take a look at disgrouping of pixels. We know what that should look like in the game I showed you. It should look like grass and dirt ground. I can now that it's in black RGB mode, notice they're not bad pixels, they're good pixels. That means that I can translate it through the current palette. So if I click on this, I can see what happens. My zero color translated through this, my one color translated through this color, my two color translated through brown, and my three color translated through blue. This is not a good palette for this tile set. So if I wanted to see a good palette for this tile set, this would be black, and this would be a lighter color green. And now I have something that kind of resembles this might be a lighter color brown like that, or it might be darker. It depends on what I'm going for. But now this is resembling what I saw when I looked at it in the platform game over here in this, right? So if I look at the ground here, now this is resembling that. So if you look at the tiles that the palette that I set up here, kind of looks the same, other than I haven't set blue to sky yet. But yeah, so now you can kind of see blue, green, brown, black, blue, green, brown, black. And these aren't, it's not creating a bitmap with those colors. It's actually creating a bitmap with these colors. And I'm forcing it to four values, which is allowing it to be translated through the sub palette of choice. All right, so I wanted to show you a little bit about how that works. And now let's look at how you can use this tool to create graphics. First of all, I can just make a new graph. This is a 16 by 16 pixel image, and you can turn on 16 by 16. You can see all the pixels. This is literally all the pixels in the image. You could turn on an 8 by 8 grid. You could turn on a 16 by 16 grid, which is hard to see right now. It's the entire image. So if I made a new main tile set, you can kind of see the blue squares here are the tiles. So if I turn off 8 by 8, that's my tiles for a main tile set. If I was looking at the 8x8 tiles, like I was creating objects and monsters and things like that, I could look at that, and those are my 8x8 pixel tiles. So I could turn on grids in order to kind of guide me. I could turn on and off the pixel grid. And then some of the tools are your basic drawing tools, which you should be intimately familiar with if you've ever done any graphics work at all on any computer ever. You've got a selection tool, a pencil tool, a rectangle tool, a line tool, some bucket fill tools, very basic stuff. So keep in mind that what you're going to be seeing determines on which mode you have. Either you are looking at it in black, red, green, blue, which is the actual file, or you're translating black, red, green, blue through the palette. Now see, all this is actually black, so that's the zero color. When I translate it, it's going to translate through this first choice, this first slot, which is why it turned blue. So if I go ahead and I draw a rectangle using the red color, what I'd expect is this is going to translate through the first color and it should turn green when I click this button. And there it is. So rectangle is very easy to use. You can pick a color either here or up here. Doesn't matter. You could pick a color and draw a rectangle and it fills in the rectangle. Or you can take a line tool and you could draw lines using the color that you have selected. Or you could use a global tile color tile change, which means if I have a color selected, let's say I have green selected and I click on blue, that means for the entire tile set, that's going to turn to the color I have selected. If I do a select tile fill, which is just it's going to do this 8x8 area. So if I want to turn just this, it's going to turn it in just that 8x8 tile. It's going to change the color. Also, I can copy and paste by getting the selection tool. Sometimes it's a little bit easier to turn on the pixel grid. And if I wanted to just grab that much of it, I could hit Control C. And I know that it copied because the selection went away. And then wherever I put my mouse, the top left corner of my mouse, that little pointer, the top of the index finger, is where I'm going to paste if I hit Control V. So that's how you can use the copy and paste function. So generally, the way that you're going to be doing things is you're going to be creating graphics and copying them, and you're going to be opening your graphic assets. So if I wanted to, and I'm in the wrong file here, I want to be in my game one, I'm going to be in the graphic assets. If I wanted to be working on tile set zero, I would open up tile set zero, and now I could paste that graphic into tile set zero. And don't forget, I'm seeing it in red, green, blue right now. I could also translate it through the palette. In fact, if it's easier for you to see it translated through the palette, so long as it's in black, red, green, blue, then you could translate through the palette. I can also draw in black, red, green, blue. So if I wanted to create let me get green. If I wanted to create the top of a cliff, and it would be green and brown, and it would have these sort of black lines running through it and a bunch of black dots, I could draw it like that if it's easier for me to see how it would actually look. But if I want to actually see it as it's really going to look in a bitmap, this is how it's really going to look in a bitmap. Now, when I'm done with that, I can save that BMP, which if I've opened up something like the first tile set or one of those from the graphics asset bank folder, it's going to save it over the top of that. Yes, I want to reload it, and now if I look at my assets, there it is. It's changed. I automatically changed that. Or if I want to save this over the top of, say, I want this to be a new tile set, like tile set number one, I could save it over the top of that. I can replace it, and now if I look, it's over the top of one. If I just want to start from scratch, I could get the color. I could go to black, red, green, blue, color it all with the color black, and I could save this, and I could also save it over. And I need to make sure that I am always reloading the changes. So there we go. So now I'm back to fresh start. So that's a look real quick at some of the, and you could also, by the way, I'm sorry, you can also change which palette you're looking at it through. And don't forget, if you make changes to the palettes, like I made changes to this palette to look like this, now that palette looks like that. So it's not going to look good with my grassland anymore. It was more geared towards what the platform game should look like. So that's a quick look at the tools that are available to you in the built-in pixel editor for Nestmaker.